Good day, my audience. My name is Williams Nathan Blessing Amajiri. I'm a teacher of Agri Science in Nigerian Korean Model School in PUA, located in PUA Airport Road. This day, today, I'm going to be talking about tools. Tools and effects of curriculum based teaching. I'm learning for model school. And the topic implies, I said, is tools and effects of what? Curriculum-based teaching. Now, when we talk about tools, look at what is with me. This is an example of tools, like a guideline, or like can help to help you to achieve your desired aim. So, tools and effects of curriculum-based teaching and learning from model school. What we'll be looking at based on this topic, we'll be looking at the meaning of curriculum, curriculum-based teaching. We'll also be looking at the tools that are used in curriculum, and thirdly, we'll be looking at importance of curriculum and its advantages and disadvantages. Now, first of all, we'll be looking at meaning of curriculum. Curriculum is a program of study. And curriculum is a sequence of course. What do we mean by that? For this curriculum to be very effective, or there have to be uniformity in teaching. That's why it is called curriculum. Meaning that if you are teaching this particular subject with this particular scheme in this particular location, it should not be different from what is taught in another location. In case of national exam, both nations or both regions can participate. But when there is no curriculum, teaching is scattered. People teach what they feel, what they think. But curriculum is like a guide to guide a particular nation. Another purpose of this curriculum is it covers the national goals. Every nation has its own goal, especially Nigeria. For example, one of our national goals is acquisition of skills. When we say acquisition of skills, skills that children can use on their own. They can be able to be self-reliance. Self-reliance in the sense that they don't rely on white-collar job. Nigeria particularly cannot provide white-collar job to every graduate in Nigeria. But the help of curriculum, like for example, curriculum, one of the subjects taught in curriculum is curriculum introduced is agricultural science. Agricultural science to teach about planting, farming. You can see an example of what is taught in agricultural science. This is aquatic animals, meaning of livestock. Now, if your children acquire skills, they are able to learn from agricultural science of raising livestock on their own. Within their own location, they can have a small pond. They can even have a they can even have a small farm by the side of their house, and they can raise livestock and also plants, for instance. Because in NKMS here in this school, we teach children how to acquire skills so that they cannot be a burden on people, because that's what the national goals covers. So it helps them even when they're out of school, they are able to rely on their own self, not on what the government can provide. So there are things that children can easily do, and this can raise funds for them, not waiting on, oh, I graduate, government to come and give me a job. Agricultural science cancels that, because if you and it's a compulsory course in all schools, and because it's compulsory, these children are able to use it, are able to rely on themselves, not a white collar job provided, only a white collar job provided by the government. These are one. Also, these are animals also children can easily raise at home. We have different animals here. We have pig, and we have their young ones with them. We have even chicken, popular one. Children can easily raise chicken in their neighborhood, and they can raise fun from it. They can raise chickens, chickens can produce eggs, they can sell it, they can even sell the chickens that are already matured to buyers around. And with this, they can raise fun. So agricultural science teach children not just acquiring skill, also to be self-reliant, and that helps them to achieve, or helps government generally to achieve the national goals that is being stipulated for the country. Now, for this agricultural science or curriculum-based teaching also help students in Nigerian Korean Model School to expand their learning, not just as in the formal setting, also outside their own community. There are also tools that are being used to achieve this aim. One of these tools is evaluation, also checking the children's performance, assessments, accountability. Now, for this to be achieved properly, there have to be a systematic process of learning that will bring about evaluation of the children, and we'll be able to know their performance. They themselves will be able to know if they are, if they have learned, or if what they have learned is also being effective on them. For example, talking about evaluation, when tests are given, children knows their ability, knows their performance, they know areas they can improve. All schools, all educational sectors in Nigeria use curriculum to teach their lessons, because this helps learning to take place, and this helps all curriculum or all institution in the world to achieve a desired goal set out by the government of each country. Now, what are the importance of this curriculum? Curriculum makes learning interesting. Makes learning interesting in the sense that the children have a scheme they are following already. As they have a scheme, when each scheme they've been taught, they know this scheme has been taught, this scheme has been taught, and they are able to also read based on the scheme they have. It also makes teaching and learning easy. As a teacher, it makes it easy in the sense that you are able to plan based on what you have. You are not scouting for what to teach. You already know that I have this to teach for this week, I have this to teach for this week. And you plan your lesson plan. You plan your tools based on the curriculum that have been given. It also helps the facilitator, the teacher, to also deliver his lesson effectively. In the sense that the facilitator is able to develop or build more materials to help the children to reach the hearts of the students. That means to make learning student-centered, not based on just on teachers, make it teacher-centered. It also enhances teachers' ability to teach. In areas where teachers are not able to teach a particular topic, what we call TLC, which teachers are able to consult themselves together and ask questions. Now, when there is a planned curriculum, like I've been said, where curriculum is based while we're teaching is based on curriculum. Teachers know that, oh, I don't know this topic very well. I could call one or two of my colleagues. We brainstorm together and we are able to look at ways whereby I can disseminate this information based on the knowledge teachers have had about students. So it enhances teachers' ability to teach. So in that way, teacher is improved. Teacher's learning is also improved in that instances. Now, the effect of curriculum-based teaching and learning on teachers is that it helps teachers to follow a detailed topic that enhances students' academic performance. It also informs teachers what skills must be taught at each topic to prepare students for higher education or for job. Because curriculum is being used both from the primary level to the tertiary level. So it helps students to build this, teachers to build these students from the primary level. So that when they reach the higher level, they are also in tune with what the national goals wants to achieve. It's also an impact on students in the sense that for students, there's a sequence of course and tasks must be taken successfully completely within a specific period of time. Students know that, oh, within these weeks, we are going to do these topics and we are going to have tests this week, we are going to have exams. Students are not able to plan based on the curriculum, based on the scheme that we're given by the teachers and the curriculum provided by the government. Now, what are the advantages of this curriculum? This curriculum has advantages. Curriculum ensures that teachers teach students relevant topics, not just what I think, what I feel. And you are able to monitor the students' academic progress. It motivates students to learn. Students are looking forward to this topic. Oh man, when are you going to teach this topic? They are looking forward to that topic, knowing that they have a lot to learn or they have a lot of questions to ask to learn more based on what you are teaching them. Curriculum also assures students that they are on the right track to reaching their goals. If for example, a child said, this topic is in your scheme, I want to learn how to farm properly or how to weed my farm, not to weed the plants, what I want to look out for. Children are able to know how to spray herbicides. Children are able to know that, oh, I want to do it. So they are eager to learn, they are eager to know so that they can reach their own goal. But curriculum has its own disadvantages because curriculum is structured. It's a planned knowledge that are meant to be imparted to students. Now, it limits teachers from giving students relevant information. I have an instance on that. Whereby you want to expatiate on a topic above what the curriculum gives, children now focus more on that extra explanations you're giving. They forget the main topic. So, teachers now limit their teaching based on the curriculum. So, it doesn't allow teachers to expand more. Because that also involve more time consuming. Also, we also have one of the other disadvantages of curriculum is that there's a repetition of topics. Most times, from junior class, topics that have been taught in junior class are also being repeated in senior class. And also, administration analyze the teaching and learning progress based on curriculum content. Therefore, they limit teachers and students' knowledge. They don't look at what areas can be improved in these instances. They just analyze based on the curriculum, oh, you should be able to do this, you should be able to do that. It is no longer based on the progress that the students are supposed to achieve, whether it is based on just the curriculum. That's one of the disadvantages of curriculum. Now, conclusively, curriculum-based teaching and learning is a vital tool to all educational institutions in Nigeria. If the purpose for the establishment of the curriculum is to be established, is to be achieved, if the purpose for the national goals is to be established, curriculum is very, very important. So every institution should make use of curriculum, because if they don't make use of curriculum, it will not achieve desires in like acquisition of skill, self-reliance, and also not relying on white collar, but relying on oneself. Thank you.